Welcome to this LUSAS presentation. This is part two of a three-part series looking at footbridge dynamics with LUSAS. In this session, we're going to look at progressing a linear static analysis to modal dynamics. In session one, we built this linear static footbridge model and we applied self-weight. We're now going to turn this into a modal dynamics model. To do this, we're going to create a second analysis. Now, this analysis will inherit the properties from the base model, the geometry, the material, the supports. I'm going to call this analysis 2 eigenvalue. And then I'm going to OK. I will then get a second analysis in the analysis tab in the tree view. I'm going to right hand mouse button on this load case and go to controls eigenvalue. We're going to look at frequencies. We're going to look at minimum. However, I could look at a range. Minimum is 0 Hz upwards. And I'm going to ask for 10 frequencies to be found. The model can now be solved. So save and solve the model. Only analysis 2 needs to be rerun. And I can then look at my eigenvalue results. I'm just rotating the model around. I'm switching off the flashing. I'm just going to move the model slightly to the right so I can see it slightly better. Now, this mode appears to be a lateral mode at 1.8 Hz. If I look at mode 2, again appears to be a lateral mode at 3 Hz. Mode 3, a bit more difficult. I'm just going to rotate this around and resize it. And I'm going to go to the deform mesh layer and increase the deformation. Yep, so it's a vertical mode. And this is occurring at 3.6 Hz. And eigenvalue 4. This appears to be a twisting mode. Now, I'm going to go back to eigenvalue 3. I'm going to switch back on the flashing. I'm going to switch off my mesh, switch off the geometry. And if I toggle the flashing off on and off, I will get it on the deform shape. I'm going to go to the utilities menu and I'm going to do an animation of the active load case. And this is going to apply a sine wave to my deform shape. So there's the animation of my deform shape. And this can be saved as an AVI if I want. I'm just going to close it down. Now, currently, the results that I've found are based on the structural mass. But it's important when you do a bridge like this that anything like the non-structural deck plates, the parapets, any bridge furniture is also added as mass, but with no stiffness. So what we're going to do is add some lumped mass along the bottom chord of this model. I'm just going to look side on. I'm going to switch off the flashing and I'm going to put lumped mass points along the bottom here. I'm going to go to attributes, mesh, point, and it's the point mass option that I want. And I'm going to do three dimensional. I'm going to call this added mass elements. If I hit finish, they appear in the tree view. Now I'm going to select these points along the bottom chord, the end ones, all the ones along here and the other end. And I can then drag on my added mass elements. Now, if I switch back on the mesh layer, you'll see these as large gray dots. So those are the added mass locations. I now need to specify how much mass I want at each location. Now we're going to do this with just a single mass item, and I'm going to put 500 kilograms in the X, the Y, and the Z. Now, this doesn't mean I'm applying 1500 kilograms, it's just defining how much mass is acting in each of those directions. I'm going to call this now mass 500 kilograms. Okay that, and it appears in the tree view. Now I need to select the locations of the added mass. So right hand mouse button on them, select assignments, picks them all, and I can drag on my mass attribute. Now I need to assign this into analysis 1 because that's the self-weight case. Analysis 2 will also inherit those properties. I'm going to solve the model and I'm going to look at eigenvalue 3. Now in the first run we had a frequency of 3.6 Hz. This is now changed to 3 Hz. So it's very important that when you do modal dynamics you consider both the structural mass and the non-structural mass, because it will make a difference to the results you're seeing. Now, thank you for your time. Now, if you wish to find out more about LUSAS, please go to the LUSAS website at lusas.com.